friends, let us now learn some important points about croup or laryngotracheobronchitis. So this croup or laryngotracheobronchitis, it is actually the dangerous infection which is most commonly seen in children. As the name says, it will involve the trachea and the bronchial tree. What is the most common cause? It is caused by parainfluenza virus. It is caused by parainfluenza type 1 and 2 virus, and it is caused by influenza virus. It is caused by parainfluenza type 1 and type 2 most commonly. It is caused by influenza virus. It is also caused by respiratory syncytial virus. So most common causes are parainfluenza type 1 and 2, influenza type A and respiratory syncytial virus. These are in children. Then what about in adults? In adults, it is actually caused by herpes simplex virus, cytomegalovirus, and it is caused by influenza. It is caused by herpes simplex virus, cytomegalovirus, and it is caused by influenza. In adults, it can also be caused by superimposed bacterial infection, can also cause this stridor. Superimposed bacterial infection can also cause this acute laryngotracheobronchitis. Okay, now if you see the most commonly it is seen between 6 months to 3 years of age, and it is also seen in children less than 7 years of age are mainly susceptible. So here in the subglottic area, you will see presence of mucosal swelling will be seen in the subglottic area, with production of tenacious mucin will be produced, and there will be a formation of pseudomembrane will also occur. So all this will obstruct or block the airway. So because of that, you will see respiratory distress in the children. Now, what about the clinical features? Clinical features are, it is actually gradual onset with upper respiratory tract symptoms, like the patient has fever, and the fever in the patient is actually, there is low grade fever is present with painful croupy cough. There is low grade fever with painful croupy cough, also called as barking cough, or also called as seal barks cough. Okay, here the stridor which you see is initially inspiratory stridor is present, followed by it becomes biphasic stridor will be seen. And also, if you see the upper respiratory tract obstruction, in upper airway obstruction, you will see because it is an upper airway obstruction, there will be suprasternal and intercostal retractions will be seen. Suprasternal and intercostal retractions will be seen in the upper airway obstruction, because in the laryngotracheobronchitis. Now, if you see on X-ray, you will see presence of steeple sign is seen on X-ray, and you will also see steeple sign is seen. That is, if this is the area, you will see narrowing of systemic steepling or narrowing or funnel shaped narrowing of the subglottic area. This is subglottic area which is shown as funnel shaped narrowing in the X-ray. Okay, then you will have to treat it. The treatment is mainly by, you can use broad spectrum penicillins can be used. So in the broad spectrum penicillins are used which will cause secondary bacterial infections. These broad spectrum penicillins are mainly used for secondary bacterial infections. But you were asked about the main symptom, main treatment. So this is not the main treatment. This is mainly for secondary bacterial infection. But in children, bacterial infection is not common. So what do you give? In these patients, you will give IV fluids are given, and you will also give nebulization is given with adrenaline. Nebulization with adrenaline is given, and you will also see racemic adrenaline or epinephrine mixture is given, which is 2.25% diluted in normal saline is given in the children. Okay, here there is more respiratory obstruction. So because of this respiratory obstruction, we mostly prefer doing tracheostomy or intubation in the patients. Now, what are the indications of this intubation in the patients? Intubation is done if there is increased CO2 levels, or if the neurological status is actually worsening, or if there is decreased respiratory rate. In these cases, we do intubation. So what are the indications of intubation? Indications of intubation are in raising carbon dioxide levels or in worsening neurological status. Raising carbon dioxide levels, worsening neurological status, and decreased respiratory rate, we do intubation. Now, if you were asked one-liner, What is the most common cause of infectious in respiratory obstruction in children? Most common cause of infectious respiratory obstruction in children is laryngotracheobronchitis. Most common cause of infectious respiratory obstruction in children is laryngotracheobronchitis. Thank you.